This video is sponsored by Milanote. Try it for free by using the link in the description. Let me know if any of this sounds familiar to you. You have trouble staying organized, you're easily distracted, and the ever-important planning process is the hardest part of every video that you make. Me friggin' too. And yet, every person that you talk to will tell you just how important that planning phase is. And the worst part is, they're right. So in this video, we're gonna take a look at how I simplify and declutter the planning process of my YouTube videos with the help of a tool called Milanote. I'll show you my planning process, my template, and also explain why I approach things the way that I do. So secure the cup and let's do some planning. For 5 years now, I've been making a video for my YouTube channel every single week. Throughout that time, I've learned a ton about how to get from idea to publishing, and there are a few things that really work well for me. First of all, keep it simple. If you take a look at my YouTube planning template on Milanote, it might look like there's not a lot going on, and you're right. What I've done is taken the tools that Milanote offers me, which is a lot, and I've boiled it down to just what's necessary to get me from point A to point B so that I don't get distracted or overwhelmed. One of the things that I've tried to do with my planning board is to make everything that I need easily accessible and clean. I do this by trying to have everything that I need on a single board and arranged almost like post-it notes. If I do need more detail on any specific project or video, I can absolutely create more layers of boards within boards. I can use reference images. I can use arrows to point to things if I wanted to. Any number of organizational tactics that Milanote gives me, but for me, if I add too much, I just get distracted and overwhelmed. It can be very tempting to make my boards as aesthetically beautiful as some of the other creators that I see doing more detailed and complicated plans, but my brain just freezes up when I have too much going on. What I love about my board is that there are only seven distinct sections, and if I hit Z to zoom out, you can see the entire board. It's all very obvious and simple for me to find exactly what I need at that moment in time. But let's break that down a bit, and I'll show you exactly how I go about planning the video. When I first open Milanote, I have a kind of homepage that gives me flexibility to expand for any high-level organization that I might need. As it currently stands, I've got three boards on there. There's my project ideas board, my inspiration board, and my current YouTube projects board. I've linked these with lines because I just think it looks cool, and I've also dropped an image on there that I created just to remind myself of the things that I can do when I'm feeling stuck. I haven't actually started using the project ideas or inspiration board yet, but those will be things that I'll use that don't necessarily fit into the YouTube category. So hopping into the current YouTube projects board, I've basically created a kind of a pseudo Kanban board style page. This is basically just to keep track of the projects that I'm currently working on and the stage of the process that they're in. Each of these are just a column that I dragged in from the left-hand side and customized by adding a title and a color. We've got planning, production, scheduled, and posted categories, and then there's a placeholder for my template board in case I want to edit it. So when it's time to start planning a new video, I drag a new board into the planning column, give it a name, a color, and an icon, and I dive in. Right off the bat, Milanote asked me if I want to choose a template. They've got a whole bunch of pre-made templates if something like that would work for you, but I created one for myself, so I head to More Templates, Your Custom Templates, and choose that one. Now we can see the blank version of those seven areas that I was talking about before. Once again, these are super simple columns that I then add things into. The first column is my inspiration and research area. So before I dive into outlining or scripting, I start by doing some research and seeing if I can find any useful information or inspiration for how I want my video to be. If I come across anything, I'll copy that link and paste it here in case I want to reference it later. Milanote makes nice little previews here, which makes it nice to look at, but it's also super easy to navigate. The next section is for title ideas, and while this might seem like something that should happen after I've planned the video, coming up with a good title can actually be a great way to decide on the direction of a video. A good place to start is by asking a question that you would be searching for when you're trying to find out about the topic that you want to make a video on. Then from there, you can try to make it more intriguing or more appealing for people to click on. There are a couple of tools that I use to help me decide on my titles, There's a site called Morning Fame where I can search for keywords and see what people are looking for, and another site called Headline Analyzer that gives you a score based on how effective your title will be. So I try to come up with a couple of good title options and I put them in here. Below this, you'll see the Important Points column. This is just a dumping ground for any ideas that I think are going to be important to get into the video. This has almost no organization at this point. It's basically just brainstorming as I'm researching, and I'll make sure it all gets organized later on. Which brings us to the next column, the outline. I have this column broken up into 5 different notes. There's intro, 3 blank sections, and then a conclusion. This is just a really rough idea of how I structure my videos to start with. The intro is usually just a friendly greeting and a teaser of what to expect in the video. Then sections 1 through 3 are generally any big important points, almost like chapters. Sometimes I end up adding more and sometimes I don't need all 3, but I found that 3 seems to be kind of the sweet spot to start with. And then the conclusion is a quick wrap up and any specific call to action that I feel is necessary. For the outline, I'm starting to organize those important points into some kind of a structure, but it's still not super detailed. Just below that outline, there's a link to a separate document that's pulled in from the left-hand side. Again, this is called Script. Because this ends up being a lot longer, it's nice to have it in its own document, and I'll often open up 2 browser windows side by side so that I can reference my outline while I write my detailed script. When I write my script, I do it in my own voice as much as I can. I just write it how I would naturally say it, rather than trying to sound fancier or smarter than I actually am. And I do still like to use a bullet point format in my script. I just find it easier to use later on that way. Going back to the main document, the next column is a checklist style note for my shot list. At this point, I don't always need a shot list because my videos are generally fairly simple to keep track of, and I'm the only one shooting, but sometimes it's nice to have that extra level of guidance. If I'm shooting in more than one location, I can create multiple notes with titles and their own little checklist within this column to keep myself organized. These checklists are also nice and easy to pull up on the Milanote app on my phone to use while I'm shooting, so I don't always have to have my laptop out there. And finally, I've got my publishing checklist, which is a list of all the things that I need to do to either get ready to publish or after I've published for promotional purposes. This list includes having captions made, making chapter markers, double checking my video description, title, thumbnail, and some promotional items for Instagram, Twitter, and my website. And of course, once the video is done and published, I head back to my current YouTube projects board and I move it from production or scheduled into the publish category. And I can hide the publish category as it gets longer and longer, so I don't always have to look at it. Now, I know I went on and on earlier about my simplicity, but there are a few little extra things that are important to talk about as well. The first thing that I can't state the importance of enough is having a solid template. Making a template is super easy. You just create a new board, toss everything that you want to have in every project of that type on there, and then right click and choose convert to template. The tricky part is really just refining it. I started out with way too much stuff on my template and gradually whittled it down to what it is now. I prefer to have to manually add a few things here and there when I need them, rather than to have to delete them every single time that I don't. But speaking of which, there are a couple of things that sometimes can be helpful when I'm shooting. For certain projects, I'll want to throw together a kind of a mood board or examples of the kinds of shots that I want to get. What I'll do for this is to create a board in the inspiration and research column and start dragging pictures in here or searching them in Milanote itself. The other thing that sometimes is helpful specifically for review videos where I'm gonna need to shoot a lot of test photos or test videos is to create an extra board under the shot list category with its own set of checklists. This way I can make sure to get all the test shots I need and I don't need to go back for anything afterwards. But these 2 little extras only make it into the process sometimes when it's necessary. And other than that, like I said, keep it simple. For me, the goal of any organization is just to declutter all the thoughts and ideas swimming around in my brain, so this rather simple setup in Milanote is perfect. It's just enough for me to organize my ideas and keep on track, but not so much that it gets in my way of understanding what I need. But that's my process and how I'm currently using Milanote to plan my YouTube videos. I hope that was helpful for you. And as always, I want to hear from you. What would you add to your planning board to make it work better for your projects? Leave a comment down below, and on your way down there, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button, hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on future videos. Huge thank you to Milanote for sponsoring this video. Make sure to hit that link in the description and try it out for free. If you're anything like me, I know you're gonna love it for organization and planning. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.